I've got a new bit of juiciness that have just been released from Descript, and we're talking about the collab, the joining of the forces between Squadcast and Descript. So Descript, in their season 5 announcement, announced that you can now use Squadcast in Descript to record remote recordings. I wanted to test this out, and I know it's still in beta mode, but I wanted to test it out for all you DIYers out there as to whether this would be good enough for you to use for your remote recordings. If you already use Squadcast and you use Descript, this is cool because now you don't have to pay for both of them. At time of recording, it is now included in your Descript subscription. I'm going to do a test for you, and then I'm going to give you my feedback on what I think about this new thing. When you first click on Descript and you go to new and you go to remote recording, it's going to ask you to connect your Squadcast account, or if you don't have Squadcast, you're going to have to sign up to Squadcast. It only takes a few minutes and then you're kind of ready to roll. Then you'll be faced with a dashboard. From within this dashboard, you can create a new session. Okay, and you can start the session now or you can schedule a session. So I'm going to start a session. Okay, so then you're in this studio room where it first sets you up, and you're not in anywhere yet, you're just setting up your things. You can see here for me, this is the webcam at the moment. I can change the equipment, my microphone, I don't want it to be coming through my cam link. So we've got me in nice mode, not webcam mode. And then we can just go, yep, join the session. So then we're going to record, join the session. You can see here that it is telling me that it is in 720p. 25 frames a second, and it's 44 hertz. So this to me looks beautiful, right? I look absolutely beautiful. My camera's amazing. Everything looks awesome. Then I can just hit record if I were wanting to record by myself, or I can invite someone to the room and bring them in as well. You can invite people by this invite link here, copy link. And then you can send that link to whoever you're going to send it to, which in my case, I'm going to see whether our lead designer, Alex, is available for a quick little demo on this. Hi, Alex. Okay, everyone, this is Alex. Alex is the lead designer here at Bamby Media. So now we're going to hit record. Record, and it's going to do a countdown timer. 5, 4, 3, 2. Now Alex is gone. We can leave the session, but we can also hit this little edit in Descript button. It's going to bring up the web version of Descript, and it's going to ask me where to put this thing. So I'm going to put it in here for now, just the workspace. I'm going to create the project and import the files. I'm going to open the desktop app because that's where I prefer to do things. I don't use it on the web. Okay, so now it has imported into Descript, and we can see here that we've got Alex. Look how wonderful he looks. And we've got me in there somewhere as well. If we go to right click the sequence, then you'll be able to see that there's two speakers in there. There's me and then there's Alex. So now I'm going to play you that video that I just recorded using Squadcast. I've done just a few little kind of edits to it. I wanted to keep it fairly minimal just because, for a DIYer, I don't know how detailed you're getting into the actual editing of the episode, switching speakers, split screening, that sort of thing, which you can all do in Descript. So I did a little bit of it. I'm going to play that video for you right now. So, Alex, let's do a bit of movement, like we're talking, we're having a conversation.
Realistically speaking and gesticulating. Yes.
Yes.
That's easy to authentically do.
Yes, exactly. Hello, look, now I'm pointing at something and I'm really excited. Now, most people won't be that animated, will they? They'll just be talking like this.
Yeah, so I think straight away I can notice, I mean, in this situation, there's probably about a half second lag between your audio and video, even looking at mine, there also seems to be a visible lag as well, but I'm not sure if that is going to affect conversational flow.
Okay, cool. So now, thanks so much for that, Alex. We've had such a great conversation on our podcast today, and
that'll be $2,000.
That'll be $2,000. Yeah. Okay. Now I'm going to stop recording. Now you may have noticed in that video that my quality was nowhere near as good as Alex's was. I have a fairly high-end setup here. I record in 4K. You can see the quality of it. I'm using OBS right now to record, and it's beautiful. But with Squadcast, I'm recording in 4K, and it's received 4K, but my bit rate and my my frames per second, it's much less. Alex, even though he was coming in at, again, 4K, it's recorded only in 720p and the settings are a little bit different. I'll show you both Alex and Brianna what came in from Squadcast so that you can see what the situation is there. For me and for anyone using a 4K setup as the host, I would have to go into the menu, change to make sure that it's not getting 4K so that we don't have that kind of issue. Now, for me, that's a pain in the ass, and I wouldn't do that because I don't want to have to change my setup just to record using Squadcast. So for me personally, unless anyone in the comments has any feedback as to any changes that I need to make in the Squadcast end, I know that Squadcast can record up to 1080p, which is good, but we're still having these frame rate and bitrate issues in Squadcast, meaning that the quality is not where I would want it to be to get the outcome that I want to get. Now, for someone that's just starting out, maybe you don't have a really high quality setup, maybe you have a decent webcam that can do 1080p, this may be a completely fine option for you to get decent quality from Squadcast without having to pay for a different platform like Riverside or, you know, Zencast or anything, and record it all using Descript and Squadcast. There may be updates, there may be upgrades, there may be things that they're going to change in Squadcast to get it to where it needs to be for Descript for me as a high-end user of this kind of gear. So that's a little bit of a run-through for you as to Squadcast and using Descript. It's very easy once you get it all into Descript and you can, you know, edit like you normally would, and it will come in there. Just make sure you name things properly and that you have them in the right folders and all that sort of thing so you can find them easily. I do like that it integrates really smoothly. I do like that it's free for people at the moment at time of recording. I'm not sure what they're going to do after the beta round is over, but for right now, for me, it's not going to cut the mustard, but it may very well for you if you're not operating such a high-end setup. I hope this video has been valuable for you. If it has been, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. I'm really interested in giving you the hot takes on what is happening in the podcasting space in the world for the industry, upgrades, trends, all that sort of thing. So if that interests you, then this is a channel you will want to be subscribed to. So go for it. Thanks for joining me today. And if you have anything you want to add, please hit the comments, write all the things in there, and I'll review them. If you've got any tips, I would love to hear them.